weather, as you've everybody's seen, is extremely unpredictable.
From here is the town of Ulmurra. It's a small town on the banks of the Clarence River where an evacuation warning has been issued.
It appears that if the projections come to pass, that Ulmurra will be isolated.
At the moment, we're actually waiting for someone to be rescued from a back road from Tyndale to Jacobia. G'day, I'm John Leask, the New South Wales SES Ulmurra Unit Commander. Are you flood ready? Although there's a levee here facing the Clarence River, Ulmurra, Tucabia and in between is affected by the Coldstream River and small tributaries like Swan Creek. Some properties may be isolated and some roads like Big River Way and local roads may close during a major flood. So, whether you've lived in the area for a long time or never experienced a flood, it's important to know what to do before, during and after a flood event.
Each year, you need to prepare or update your flood plan for your family, your property and animals, or your business. You can download a home or business flood emergency plan from ses.nsw.gov.au. But wouldn't you like to be prepared so you never need to call us?
During a flood, there are many ways to get information. ABC and local radio stations will keep you informed. The Bureau of Meteorology will issue flood warnings, and emergency services may issue information advising you of consequences and impacts and actions you need to undertake, including evacuation. It's good to listen to locals who have been through floods before. Oh, and you can pick up this flood brochure from the Jacobia store, the Ulmurra server, and the Coldstream gallery. It has local info, preparation tips, contact numbers, and websites you might need. Remember to look out for your neighbours too, and check that they are okay. They may be vulnerable, isolated, or new to the area, and have never experienced a flood before.
Don't forget to prepare your home or business with sandbags from the SES. They're free and the SES volunteers will give you assistance if you need it. Keep up to date with the Live Traffic New South Wales app and Disaster Dashboard, Clarence Valley and My Road Info websites. And if you're out and about on the roads during a flood, make sure you plan your trip. There are roads like this one which are severely affected with floodwater. And remember, don't drive, ride or walk through floodwater. If it's flooded, forget it.
After a flood is over, emergency services will advise when it's safe for you to go in and clean up or to return to your home if you've been evacuated.
Floodwater can contain hazards such as household, medical and chemical waste. Downed power lines, timber and other debris, and wild animals including rodents and snakes. You may need qualified people to check your electricals, and perhaps even the stability of your home.
There's lots of different roles you can do at SES, like floodboat operators, swift water rescue technicians, storm and water damage teams, community liaison officers, public information and media, unit administration officers, training coordinator, maintenance officers and catering crews. There's probably a role for everyone. SES Ulmurra volunteers are locals, just like you and me. People who care about the communities we live in. Check out ses.newsouthwales.gov.au, your online guide about before, during and after floods. Be aware, keep informed and stay safe. So come and join us!